Hello everyone, myself Satish Kalra. Welcomes all of you in my channel Ultimate Science by Satish Kalra. And today we are starting Chapter 1 Basic Concept in Chemistry of Class Plus 1. In previous classes, you have studied that there are mainly three branches of science. One is physics, second is chemistry, and third one is biology. Now, as our subject is chemistry, so first of all, what is chemistry? So chemistry, as the name indicates, it is made up of word chemi. So chemistry word related to chemi. Chemi means chemical. So what is chemistry? It is a branch of science which deals with the study of different elements. In this branch, we study about the different elements, compounds, chemical changes, and various type of chemical reactions occurring in our surroundings. It means the branch of science which is related with the study of different elements, compounds, chemical changes, and various types of chemical reactions which are occurring in our surroundings, in our body, and all this is covered in chemistry. Next topic. Next is matter and its classification. First of all, what is matter? Matter, you have studied in the lower classes, that the matter is what? Anything which occupies space, has mass, and whose presence can be felt by any of our five senses. You know that human body has five type of sense organs, and if any object can be felt by any of our five sense organs, and it is having space as well as mass, then that object is considered in the category of matter. Next. Next is physical classification of matter. We know classification means dividing any substance on the basis of their characteristics. So first is physical classification of matter. It means classification of matter on the basis of their physical characteristics. So as per physical classification of matter, matter is mainly of three types. One is solid, second one is liquid, and third one is gas. In lower classes, you have studied about solid, liquid, and gases. So here, I am going to recall that topics. First is characteristics of solids. All the solids have definite shape. It means their shape is fixed. Secondly, they have definite volume. It means their volume is also fixed. The constituent particles are tightly packed. So, if we draw any solid, suppose this is the arrangement of solid. These circles represent constituent particles. And you are observing that the constituent particles, these are tightly packed. So, in case of solids, the constituent particles are tightly packed. The distance between constituent particles is negligible. This is one particle, this is second particle, and these two particles are joining each other. Yeah, these two particles are attached with each other, and the distance between these particles is negligible, na kebraba distance. And the forces of attraction between constituent particles very strong. In the chemistry, the distance is inversely proportional to forces of attraction. If the distance between constant particle will increase, then the forces of attraction will become weak. And if distance will decrease, then forces will become strong. And in case of solid, you are observing that the constant particles are tightly packed. Distance between them is negligible. Therefore, the forces of attraction between constant particles very strong. Next is very high density. We know density is mass per unit volume. So in case of solids, you are observing that the particles are tightly packed. So therefore, they will have higher mass for a unit volume, and that's why they will have very high density. Next is low rate of diffusion. We know about diffusion. Diffusion means the spontaneous mixing of the particles of any substance, or particles of two or more substances of their own. And it depends upon the distance between the particles. If there is a distance between the particles, then particles can easily diffuse, and the particles can easily move from one place to another place. So, in case of solid, the constant particles are tightly packed and the forces of attraction between particles are very strong. That's why they can't diffuse. They will, we can say, they will diffuse very slowly एंड वी विल से दैट दे विल हैव लो रेट ऑफ डिफ्यूजन, इनके डिफ्यूजन की स्पीड कम होगी. नेक्स्ट इज सॉलिड्स आर जनरली इनकॉम्प्रेसिबल. सो इनकॉम्प्रेसिबल वर्ड कम्स फ्रॉम ए वर्ड कॉम्प्रेसिबिलिटी. सो व्हाट इज कॉम्प्रेसिबिलिटी? इफ बाय अप्लाइंग प्रेशर ऑन एनी ऑब्जेक्ट आइदर द शेप ऑफ एनी ऑब्जेक्ट गेट्स चेंज्ड और द कॉन्स्टेंट पार्टिकल कम क्लोजर देन दिस क्रैक्टर इज कॉल्ड कॉम्प्रेसिबिलिटी एंड द सब्सटेंस इज कॉल्ड कॉम्प्रेसिबल सब्सटेंस. कि हमने किसी सब्सटेंस के ऊपर प्रेशर लगाया और प्रेशर लगाने से यदि पार्टिकल या तो क्लोज आ जाए या उसकी शेप ही चेंज हो जाए then that substance is called compressible and this criteria is called compressibility. And we know in case of solids, the constant particles are tightly packed. So if we apply pressure on any object, any solid object, then the particles cannot close further, cannot come closer further. It means the particles cannot close. Secondly, the shape of the shape of the solid substance remains as such. So therefore, solids are generally incompressible. Here I have used word generally. Generally means there are some exceptions. For example, in case of foam, in case of rubbers, they can be compressed. So that's why solids are generally incompressible. It means 99.9% solids are incompressible. 1.1% they can be compressed. Next is solids are rigid in nature. Rigid word comes from the rigidity. So what is rigidity? If the constituent particles of any substance occupy fixed positions and they cannot move, means they can only oscillate about their mean positions. कि वो सिर्फ अपनी जगह पे ही हल्का फुल्का oscillate कर सके, vibrate कर सके, हल्का फुल्का हिल डुल सके, but they cannot move. Then this criteria is called rigidity. And as you are observing that in case of solid particles are closely packed, so these particles cannot move from one place to another place. That's why solids are rigid in nature and this criteria is called rigidity. Examples of solid: brick, table, chair, foam, rubber, etc. This is all about solids. Next is characteristics of liquids. In liquids, they have no definite shape. It means they take the shape of vessel in which they are kept. For example, if we are having 1 liter milk, if we put them in glasses, then it will acquire the shape of glasses. If you put them in a bowl, then it will take the shape of bowl. It means all the liquids have no definite shape. Next, they are having definite volume. It means 1 liter milk will remain 1 liter wherever the vessels are changed, but the volume remains same. In the case of liquid, the constant particles are loads. So whenever we draw the arrangement of constant particles in liquid, then you can see the constituent particles are loose. As the constant particles become loose, it means the distance between constant particle becomes more than that of solids. Next is, as the distance is increasing, we know distance is inversely proportional to forces of attraction. So as the distance between constant particle will increase, so the forces of attraction between constant particles become weaker than that of solids. Next thing, in case of liquid, you are observing that constant particles are loose. It means number of particles per unit volume will become less. And if the number of particles will become less, then the mass of particles will also become less. And therefore, liquids have low density. Next is high rate of diffusion, because the liquids, in the case of liquid, the particles are loose. They can move from one place to another place. That's why they will have high rate of diffusion. Liquids are also incompressible. Next is liquids are fluid in nature. One is rigidity and second one is fluidity. So what is fluidity? If the constituent particles of any substance does not occupy fixed positions and they can move from one place to another place, then this criteria is called fluidity. And the substances having this character are called fluid in nature. So liquid mein kya hai? Particles ek jahan se dusri jahan tak aasani se move kar sakte hain. Reason aap dekh rahe hain, because the particles are loose. That's why liquids are fluid in nature. It means they have fluidity character. Example of liquids are milk, oil, water, etc. Next is characteristics of gases. Gases also have no definite shape, no definite volume. The constant particles are very loose. If we see the arrangement of constant particles in case of gases, then you can observe that in case of gases, the constant particles are very loose. The distance between constant particle more than that of solids as well as liquids, solids or liquid, dono se jyada hai. And if the distance will become high, a distance will become more, then the forces of attraction between constant particle will become weak. So here the forces of attraction between constant particles are weaker than that of solids and liquids. Next is, gases have very low density. As you are observing that in case of gases, the number of particles per unit volume will become less. आप देख सकते हैं इस बॉक्स के अंदर अब कितने पार्टिकल है, सिर्फ 6 पार्टिकल्स हैं. सो नंबर ऑफ पार्टिकल्स पर यूनिट वॉल्यूम विल बिकम लेस एंड एज द नंबर ऑफ पार्टिकल्स विल डिक्रीज देन द मास ऑफ कॉन्स्टेंट पार्टिकल विल आल्सो डिक्रीज एंड एज द मास ऑफ कॉन्स्टेंट पार्टिकल विल डिक्रीज व्हेन वी नो डेंसिटी इज मास अपॉन वॉल्यूम. सो डेंसिटी इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू मास. So as the mass of constant particle decrease, the density will also decrease. So gases have very low density. Gases have very high rate of diffusion because you are observing that in case of gases, constant particles are very loose and the forces of attraction between constant particles are weakest. And this is weaker than that of solids and liquids. So these particles can easily move from one place to another place. And that's why gases have very high rate of diffusion. Next is, gases are highly compressible. It means they can be compressed. You can see the example of LPG. In the LPG case, that is the liquefied petroleum gas, this gas is supplied in the cylinder and this gas is filled in a cylinder by using high pressure. So if you apply pressure, then the particles can come close and the gas will convert into liquid state, and in liquid state that gas is filled in the cylinder. So that is the LPG. LPG full form, we know, that is the liquefied petroleum gas. Next is, gases are also fluid in nature. It means gases have the character of fluidity. It means the gases can, the molecules or the particles of gases can flow from one position to another position. That's why this character is called fluidity, and gases are also fluid in nature. So solids are rigid in nature and liquid and gases both are fluid in nature. Examples are hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, etc. So these are the example of gases. Next is some basic terms related to conversion of states of matter. It means hum solid se liquid mein convert kar rahe hain, liquid se gas mein convert kar rahe hain ya vapors mein, vapor se wapas liquid ja rahe hain. So some basic terms related to conversion of states of matter. Ke state se dusri state mein yadi convert ho raha hai to use bolte kya hai. So the first definition is, that is the melting or fusion. What is melting or what is fusion? In lower classes you have studied about melting, but there is a new word that is called fusion. So what is melting or fusion? The conversion of a solid directly into its liquid state on heating at a particular temperature. It means if we heat a solid, then at a particular temperature, this solid will convert into its liquid state. Then this process is called melting, or it is also called fusion. And the temperature at which such conversion takes place, this temperature is called melting point of that solid. For example, we know the melting point of ice is 0 degrees Celsius. So this is about melting or fusion. The next term is boiling, or it is also called vaporization. In lower classes, we have studied about boiling, but not vaporization. So boiling is having the another name, vaporization. So what is boiling or vaporization? We know that we boil milk, we boil water. It means we boil any liquid. So the conversion of any liquid into its vapor state on heating at a particular temperature. It means if we heat any liquid, then at a particular temperature, it will convert into its vapors. Then this process is called boiling, or it is also called vaporization. And the temperature at which such conversion takes place, this is called boiling point of that liquid. For example, the boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius. And in Kelvin, it is 100 plus 273, that is 373 Kelvin. And in case of melting, the melting point of ice is 0 degrees Celsius, so 0 plus 273. It is equal to 273 Kelvin. So melting point of ice is 273 Kelvin and the boiling point of water is 373 Kelvin. So this is about melting or fusion and boiling or vaporization. Next term is freezing and condensation. So what is freezing? As the name indicated, freezing means to freeze anything. And we freeze any liquid in the freezer or it will convert into the solid state. जैसे हम फ्रिज में पानी रखते हैं, पानी से बर्फ बनती है, वैसे ही सेम फ्रीजिंग. सो द कन्वर्जन ऑफ एनी लिक्विड इनटू इट्स सॉलिड स्टेट ऑन कूलिंग एट ए फिक्स्ड टेम्परेचर. इट मींस वी पुट एनी लिक्विड इनटू अ फ्रीजर, इट विल कन्वर्ट इनटू इट्स सॉलिड स्टेट ऑन कूलिंग. देन दिस प्रोसेस इज कॉल्ड फ्रीजिंग एंड द टेम्परेचर एट विच सच कन्वर्जन टेक प्लेस, दिस इज कॉल्ड फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट ऑफ दैट लिक्विड. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट ऑफ वाटर इज 0°C. It means at 0°C, the water will convert into the ice. And in Kelvin, 0 plus 273, that is 273 Kelvin. The next term is condensation. We studied about condense. What is condense or what is condensation? The conversion of vapors of any liquid into its liquid state at room temperature by cooling. It means you have observed many times that Whenever we put some water in a glass and we put some ice cubes, then on the outer surface of glass surface, on the outer surface of glass, we observe small drops of water. And these small drops of water are due to the water vapors present in the atmosphere. These water vapors strike the wall of the vessel, outer wall of the glass, and they convert into the liquid droplets. So the conversion of vapors of any liquid into its liquid state. So, किसी liquid के vapors liquid state में convert हो रहे हैं at room temperature by cooling. This is called condensation. Our next term is sublimation. You have studied this term in 9th standard. So, what is sublimation? The conversion of any solid substance directly into its vapor state without passing through its liquid state on heating. It means we heat a solid substance, it should be converted into its liquid state, but without converting into its liquid state, it will directly convert into its vapor state. And this process takes place at a temperature below the triple point of that substance. Then this process is called sublimation. For example, ammonium chloride, the formula of ammonium chloride is NH4Cl, iodine, the formula of iodine is I2, and the third is camphor. Camphor kya hai? Kapoor. जो हमारे घरों में पूजा के लिए यूज होता है. दीज आर द सब्सटेंसेस विच सबलाइम ऑन हीटिंग. हीट करने पर सबलाइम होंगे एंड कन्वर्ट इनटू इट्स वेपर्स. सो दिस इज सबलिमेशन. नेक्स्ट इज इवेपोरेशन. एज द नेम इंडिकेट्स, इवेपोरेशन, इट हैज वेपर, सो फॉर्मेशन ऑफ वेपर्स. देन इट इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द बॉइलिंग. इन बॉइलिंग वी हीट एनी लिक्विड एंड एट ए पर्टिकुलर टेम्परेचर इट विल कन्वर्ट इनटू इट्स वेपर्स. व्हाइल इन इवेपोरेशन द स्पॉन्टेनियस कन्वर्जन ऑफ any liquid into its vapors of its own at room temperature. Room temperature पर कोई liquid अपने आप से vapor में convert हो रहा है without heating. Then this is called evaporation. For example, evaporation of water from water bodies. हम जानते हैं rivers है, lakes है, sea है, इन सब से water जो है evaporate हो जाता है. And this comes in the topic water cycle. So this is called evaporation. So next we will study about the chemical classification of matter. Chemical classification of matter. On the basis of this classification, matter is mainly of two types. One is pure substances, second is impure substances. As the name indicate, pure means jisme kisi bhi tarah ki koi contamination na ho, milavat na ho. So pure substances, what are pure substances? The substances which are made up of only one kind of particles, these are called pure substances. So pure substances are further of two types. One is elements, second is compounds. So first is element. What is element? In lower classes, we have studied about sodium, potassium, calcium, magnesium. These all are the elements. So what is element? It is the purest form of any matter which cannot be further broken into smaller particles. इट मीन्स किसी मैटर की वो सबसे प्योर फॉर्म जिसको यदि हम फर्दर ब्रेकअप करना चाहें देन दे विल नॉट कन्वर्टेड इनटू स्मॉलर पार्टिकल्स एंड इट इज मेड अप ऑफ ओनली वन टाइप ऑफ कॉन्स्टेंट पार्टिकल्स एंड दीज कॉन्स्टेंट पार्टिकल्स आर कॉल्ड एटम्स. इट मीन्स ऑल द एलिमेंट्स आर मेड अप ऑफ स्मॉल कॉन्स्टेंट पार्टिकल्स एंड दीज कॉन्स्टेंट पार्टिकल्स आर कॉल्ड एटम्स. सो एलिमेंट्स जो हैं we are having 118 elements in the modern periodic table, and the elements are further of three types. One is metals, second one is non-metal, and third one is metalloids. So what are metals, what are non-metals, what are metalloids, and what are their characteristics? The first one is metals. So metals, characteristics of metals. We know about some metals: iron, magnesium, calcium, copper, silver, zinc, gold. These all are the metals. So what are the different characteristics of metal? First point, they generally exist in solid state except mercury, which is in the liquid state. Normally, the metals exist in solid state, but there is only one exception, mercury. This is present in the liquid state. Otherwise, all the metals are present in solid state. Second is, metals are generally hard, except sodium and potassium, which can be cut with knife. Metals normally kaise hain? Hard hain. And sirf inme exception kya hai? Sodium and potassium, they can be cut with knife. Next is, metals are sonorous. Sonorous means they produce sound. You know about the bells present in our schools. They are made up of metals due to the sonorous nature of metals. Next is, metals are malleable. Malleable means metals can be converted into thin sheets by using hammering. If we hammer any metal object, then it will convert into thin sheets. And this character is called malleability, and metals are malleable in nature. Next is, metals are ductile. Ductile means ductility character. If we stretch any metal, then they can be converted into thin wires. And this character is called ductility, and the metals are ductile in nature. Next is, metals have high melting point. Because metals generally exist in solid state, and in solid state, particles are closely packed. Yeah, particles are tightly packed, so they will have very high density, so they will have very high melting point, because the forces of attraction between particles are very strong. Next, metals are lustrous. Lustrous means metals have luster. That's why our ornaments are made up of metals like gold. Next, metals have tendency to lose the electrons, and they can form cations. If we see, this is a metal, it has tendency to lose one electron, then after losing one electron, it will convert into M positive. So this is metal, and it will convert into cation. So all the metals have tendency to lose the electron and convert into cations. Next is, metals are good conductor of electricity. It is due to the presence of free mobile electrons. We know metals have tendency to lose the electrons. It means they are having free mobile electrons, and due to the presence of free mobile electrons, they can conduct electricity to large extent. And that's why metals are good conductor of electricity. Next, the oxides of metals are generally basic in nature. We know about, whenever metals react with oxygen, then they will form metallic oxides. And whenever metallic oxides are further dissolved in water, then they produce base. It means metallic oxides are generally basic in nature, while in some cases, the metallic oxides are amphoteric also. So that's why we have used generally. Generally means 99.9% metallic oxides are basic in nature. Example, gold, Au, silver, Az, etc. So this is all about characteristics of metals. Next is non-metals. Characteristics of non-metals. We know in case of metals, they generally exist in solid state, but in case of non-metal, they exist in solid, liquid, as well as gaseous state. It means they can exist in all the three forms. Next, metals are generally hard and non-metals are generally soft, except diamond. Diamond is the exception, which is the hardest substance. Metals are sonorous and non-metals are not sonorous. It means they do not produce sound. Non-metals are not malleable. It means they cannot be converted into thin sheets by using hammering. They are not ductile. It means they cannot be stretched into thin wires. Non-metals have low melting point, except diamond. Diamond is an exception. Non-metals are not lustrous, except iodine. Isme iodine exception hai. Iodine mein kya hai? Chamak hoti hai. We know metals have tendency to lose the electron, while non-metal have tendency to gain the electron. Suppose H is a non-metal, then it has tendency to gain the electron. If it will gain one electron, then it will convert into H negative ion. So this is non-metal. And non-metal, after gaining electron, it will convert into anion. So non-metals have tendency to gain the electrons, and they can form anions. Next, Non-metals are bad conductor of electricity, except graphite. Graphite is the exception, which is good conductor of electricity. Therefore, different electrodes are made up of graphite. Next, non-metallic oxides are generally acidic in nature. It means whenever a non-metal reacts with oxygen, it will form non-metallic oxide. And whenever non-metallic oxide further react with water, then they produce acids. That's why non-metallic oxides are generally acidic in nature. Example, the oxide of sulfur is SO2, it is acidic in nature. Examples are hydrogen, H, oxygen, O, etc. So this is all about non-metals. The next is metalloids. So what are metalloids? Those elements which show characteristics of both metals and non-metals. जिन्हें मेटल्स और नॉन मेटल्स दोनों के करैक्टर्स हों, या ये कहेंगे दे शो इंटरमीडिएट करैक्टर्स ऑफ मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स, दीज आर कॉल्ड मेटलॉइड्स. एग्जांपल आर सिलिकॉन SI, जर्मेनियम GE, एटसेट्रा. सो दिस इज अबाउट मेटलॉइड्स एंड दीज आर द थ्री फॉर्म्स ऑफ एनी एलिमेंट. एलिमेंट एग्जिस्ट इन थ्री फॉर्म्स. वन इज मेटल, सेकेंड इज नॉन मेटल, थर्ड इज मेटलॉइड. नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज अबाउट कंपाउंड्स. नाउ व्हाट आर कंपाउंड्स? व्हेनेवर टू और मोर एलिमेंट्स are combined together in fixed ratio by mass. It means we have to combine two or more elements and they should be combined in mass-wise ratio and that ratio should be fixed. Then a new substance is formed which has entirely different properties than its constituent substances. It means whenever two or more elements will combine, it means there is a chemical change. Then a new substance is formed. Then this new substance is having entirely different properties than its constituent elements. Then this new substance is called compound. For example, water. We know water is having two elements. One is hydrogen, second is oxygen. Hydrogen exists in nature in the form of H2, H2 gas. And oxygen is also in the nature in the form of O2 gas. Both are gases, but whenever hydrogen and oxygen will combine, these two elements will combine, they form water, which generally exists in liquid state. So this is a new substance. Same way, say carbon dioxide. Carbon is solid, oxygen is gas, but CO2 form is in gases in nature. So what is, hum jo baat kar rahe hain, fifth ratio by mass. So what is the fifth ratio by mass? So if we see the example of water, then you are observing that water contains two elements. One is hydrogen, second is oxygen. So we'll take the ratio of masses of these elements. Mass of hydrogen, ratio mass of oxygen. You are observing that hydrogen is having two atoms. So we'll write the number of atoms 2. There are only one atom of oxygen in H2O, 1. We will multiply these number of atoms by their atomic masses. The atomic mass of hydrogen is 1 and atomic mass of oxygen is 16. So this is 2:16 and this is 1:8. It means in case of water, the two elements hydrogen and oxygen are combined together in 1:8 by mass. So this is the fifth ratio by mass. Next example, carbon dioxide. So in case of carbon dioxide, you are observing there are two elements. One is carbon, second is oxygen. We will take the ratio of masses of this element. So mass of carbon, ratio mass of oxygen. First of all, we will write down the number of atoms. So there are only one atom of carbon, so 1. There are two atoms of oxygen, 2. The number of atoms of carbon is multiplied by atomic mass of carbon. The atomic mass of carbon is 12 and atomic mass of oxygen is 16. So 12:32 and it is 3:8. So it means in case of carbon dioxide, the two elements carbon and oxygen are combined together in 3:8 by mass, and this is the fifth ratio in case of carbon dioxide. So whenever two or more elements combine together in fifth ratio by mass, then a new substance is formed which has entirely different properties than its constituent elements. So naya substance banaya, uski properties usko banane wale elements se bilkul alag hongi. This new substance is called compound. Example of water, carbon dioxide. Compounds are also of two types. One is organic compounds, second is inorganic compounds. As the name indicates, organic compounds. So organic compounds, what are organic compounds? Those compounds which must contain atoms of carbon element. It means there is a compulsion that the atoms of carbon element must be present. If atoms of carbon element are not present, then we cannot say any compound to be organic. So organic compounds have a compulsion that they must contain atoms of carbon element, and they are obtained from plants and animals, it means from living resources. For example, carbohydrate, proteins, fats, hydrocarbons, lipids, these all are the example of organic compounds. Next is inorganic compounds. What are inorganic compounds? Those compounds which may or may not contain atoms of carbon element. Inme carbon element ke atom ho bhi sakte hain aur nahi bhi ho sakte. So they are obtained from non-living resources such as river, sea, etc. Example are calcium sulfate, CaSO4, calcium carbonate, CaCO3. To aap dekh rahe hain CaSO4 mein carbon element ke atom nahi hai, jabki CaCO3 mein carbon element ke atom hai. Sodium nitrate, NaNO3. So these all are the inorganic compounds. So compounds are of two types. One is organic compound, second is inorganic compounds. Next is impure substances or mixtures. Impure substances or mixtures. So what are impure substances or mixtures? As the name indicates, impure means which are having impurity. Impurity means they are made up of two or more than two different substances. So whenever two or more substances are mixed together in any ratio by mass, it means hame mass wise milana hai, lekin ratio ki koi compulsion nahi hai. Chahe aap thoda sa dale, chahe zyada dale, then a mixture is formed. So the formation of mixture is a physical change. And the formation of, because in this case, we are just mixing the two or more substances. And whenever we write combining the two or more substances, it means we will react to those substances. It means we are, that change is a chemical change. And in case of mixture formation, we are only just mixing the particles, mixing the substances. So this is a physical change. So in this case, no new substances formed. You have studied in the lower classes, physical change and chemical change. So whenever two or more substances are mixed together in any ratio by mass, then a mixture is formed. And a mixture has properties like that of constant substances, because in this case, no new substances formed. Mixtures are further of two types. One is homogeneous mixture and second is heterogeneous mixture. So first is homo means same, yeah, uniform, genus means composition. It means uniform composition. Hetero means different, genus means composition. So non-uniform composition, not uniform composition, yeah, different compositions. So what is homogeneous mixture? Those mixtures which have uniform composition, jo dekhne mein bilkul ek jaisa lage, and they do not have visible boundaries of separation between the components. Jinko dekhne ke baad hum ye na bata paye ki isme kya kya component mix hai, then this is called homogeneous mixtures. For example, salt or sugar in water. If we add some sugar or salt in water, we dissolve that salt or sugar, then in case of salt solution or in case of sugar solution, we cannot demarcate or we cannot identify which substance is dissolved just by seeing. देखने से हम नहीं बता सकते. So they do not have any visible boundaries of separation between the components. So these are called homogeneous mixture. Next is heterogeneous mixture. Hetero is different or non-uniform. So those mixtures which do not have uniform composition and they have visible boundaries of separation between the components. इनमें देखने से ही पता चल जाता है कि क्या-क्या चीजें मिक्स हैं. These are called heterogeneous mixtures. For example, oil and water. वाटर में ऑयल डाल ले तो थोड़े टाइम के बाद शुरुआत में थोड़ा मिक्स होगा, लेकिन उसके बाद दो डिफरेंट लेयर्स बन जाएंगे. सो हम आसानी से आइडेंटिफाई कर सकते हैं कि वाटर के अंदर क्या चीज मिक्स है, देखने से ही बता पाते हैं. दैट्स व्हाई दे हैव विजिबल बाउंड्रीज ऑफ सेपरेशन. अनदर एग्जांपल इज चॉक एंड वाटर. सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट केमिस्ट्री, मैटर, फिजिकल क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ मैटर, सम बेसिक टर्म्स रिलेटेड टू कन्वर्जन ऑफ स्टेट ऑफ मैटर एंड केमिकल क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ मैटर. Hope you learned a lot from my video. If you like my video, then you can share my video, comment my video, and you can subscribe my channel, Ultimate Science by Satish Kalra. And in